mention off the top of the show, September is Whole Grains Month, an effort to get the American public to start thinking about eating healthier and including more whole grains in their diet. Dr. Morgan Sauer is here to tell us why that's a good thing. Why is that a good thing?
Well, first of all, naturally we're built to eat mostly a plant-based diet. I've actually been converting over to a plant-based diet, but whole grains have a lot of excellent quality nutrients that we need. Vitamin B, vitamin E, magnesium, iron, zinc, and fiber. People have noticed that in studies for heart disease and for cancer, especially cancer of the digestive tract, 30% reduction in people who eat a lot of whole grains in their diet.
Now, when you say plant-based diet, is that not vegetarian? You're still got a little meat in there, or is that just a different way to say vegetarian because of the stigma that might go with vegetarian?
Most people actually have a large meat-based diet. You go to a more toward a plant-based diet, yes, a vegetarian, like a vegan, would be a complete plant-based diet. Vegetarians are somewhere in the middle, but actually, if most people just went to mostly plants and having an occasional meat, not using meat as the main course, but almost using meat as a side dish, then health would improve dramatically in this country.
All right, what are the example you were telling me about? One example in particular that you're very high on.
This is my favorite one right now. I am eating a lot of this. It's called quinoa. You can buy it at various stores. Major grocery stores are now carrying it, and you cook it very similar to rice. It's 2 cups of water to 1 cup of quinoa. Boil it, let it simmer until the water is absorbed. You've got your grain.
What does it taste like?
It's got a little bit of a nutty flavor.
Does it need some flavoring? Does it need to be eaten with something else, with a sauce?
I like big bold food, so I like definitely some sauce, definitely some spice to it. Actually, it can even go sweet by combining it with fruit and nuts. You can actually make a sweet dish out of it.
Okay.
The best thing about this, extremely high in protein. And we all say, you know, less carbs, more protein. This is how you can get it done. We're still getting that carbohydrate
meat
texture.
Yeah.
Yeah, and you can also substitute it for meat. Fantastic stuff. Absorbs flavor great.
And then good old oatmeal.
Good old oatmeal. It's grandma and grandpa had it right. It's actually not that difficult. We need to eat 48 grams of whole grains per day. Oats are a fantastic way to start off in the morning. Additionally, you can do other things. You can take whole wheat flour and use it half and half with white flour. You can actually kind of ease your way into getting used to whole wheat flour. You can use oats in things like burgers or in meatballs. You can use it in meatloaf. You can actually take it and use it as a replacement for flour. Take a third of your flour out and use a third of oats in a lot of products like cookies and things like that, and it works great.
How much whole grains did you say you need per day?
48 grams a day.
A slice of bread, how much is that?
Processed bread, not very much.
Whole wheat bread.
Whole wheat bread, you're probably looking at a couple of grams.
Oh, okay, so you're not even close. If you eat a whole wheat sandwich, you've got a long way to go.
You need a little bit more, but it's definitely better for you.
Yeah. Any other recommendations as far as getting that amount of whole grain in your diet?
It's just being conscious and making one change at a time. People say, well, do you go drastic on this? No, you've got to ease into it. It's changing a behavior. So really saying, I'm going to eat oatmeal 3 times a day, or I'm going to use quinoa instead of maybe a pasta once a week or twice a week. And then you'll get used to it. You'll become more familiar with it. It's less scary. You can start playing around with it. Works great.
All right, Whole Grains Month. It is September, yes, and this is a good reminder that we all could use a little more whole grains in our lives. If you'd like to talk about this or other topics related to health, the Longevity Center at St. Vincent would be a great contact for you. 1 St. Vincent Circle in Little Rock. There's the number you can call for more information. Dr. Sauer, thanks for being here.
Hey, thanks to be here.
All right, more Good Morning Arkansas.